Now, Speaker Martin Romualdez hits former President Duterte for opposing charter change. Romualdez points out the former president ran a campaign that pushed for a shift to a federal form of government, but now he's changing his tune.
Unang-una, baka nahirapan naman talaga si President Duterte kasi yung plataforma, kaya nanalo siya, ay federalismo. At yan, hindi lang yung amendment ng economic provisions. Ipagbabago yung buong sistema ng government. Mukhang hindi niya nakayanan. Eh ngayon na lang may nagkukunsad na magandang move for charter amendments, baka nakikita niya na yung hindi niya magagawa, baka mangyayari na ngayon, kaya baka sinisiraan niya.
Speaker Romualdez also calling on the Dutertes to stop spreading lies about the president, adding it's too early to wish for the downfall of the Marcos administration.
So, unless we have proof na yung mga allegation ninyo na kung bakit nananawag ka din sa aking malapusin din President Ferdinand R. Marcos na buwaba sa pwesto, sana mag-isip-isip muna kayo, mag-isip muna kayo at ilabas mo yung mga prueba kasi alam natin hindi totoo yung mga sinasabi ninyo. At sa pamilyang Duterte, siguro konting galang naman sa ating mahalang presidente at saka pamilya niya. Yung pananaw naman ninyo, ginalang naman kayo, di ba? Masyado maaga naman ninyo yung gusto ipagbaksak isang rehimen ng President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr.
Senator Escudero, meanwhile, accuses House leaders of being two-faced in their push for charter change. He now dares Speaker Romualdez and other lawmakers to be transparent and stop deceiving the Senate and the Filipino people.
May naniniwala ba na hindi si Speaker Romualdez o mga mambabatas ang nasa likod nito? At the bulwark of any democracy or government is transparency and accountability. Why aren't they being transparent and accountable for this? Habang dinay-deny nila, habang multo raw yung nakikita namin, ang blow-by-blow naman na nagbibigay ng update tungkol sa People's Initiative ay puro mambabatas.
Meanwhile, Surigao del Norte Representative Robert A.S. Barber slammed senators saying they are opposing charter change because they do not want to let go or make that to go out of their comfort zones. Escudero firing back.
It's not a question of timing. It's a question of credibility. It's a question of trust or the absence or lack of trust. Lahat yan magagawa kung buo ang tiwala ng mas nakararaming Pilipino sa nagpapatupad ng pagbabago sa saligang batas, na hindi ito magiging makasarili, na ito'y para sa kapakanan lamang talaga ng bayan. Ang ginagawa nilang strategiya, dahil ang Senado hindi makumbinse, burahin na lang sa equation pagdating sa pagbabalit ng saligang batas.
As for Senator Joel Villanueva, he says the statement of Barber's only proves the end goal of the People's Initiative is to perpetuate House lawmakers into power. Senator Nancy Binay, meanwhile, remind that the lower house, any move to amend the charter, should be for the welfare of the Filipino people. Well, for Senator Cheese Escudero, Sunday's separate rallies point to the glaring breakdown of the administration's so-called Uniteam coalition. He believes with the way things are going, there's little room for unity between President Marcos and Vice President Sara Duterte. He adds the fallout began with the president's inaction on the removal of Duterte's confidential funds.
To the tune of about 98-99%. Bakit may naiwang 1-2%? Dahil nagpunta muna si Vice President Sara sa Luneta bago siya nagpunta ng Davao. So may konting tira pa, may naiiwan pa. Maanghang na salita ang binitiwan ni Pangulong Duterte, ni Mayor Baste, ni Congressman Pulong sa kanyang presensya na hindi naman niya pinagtanggol ang Pangulo at hindi naman niya pinigilang magawa o sabihin.
Following former President Duterte's tirades, Escudero says Marcos must speak out about the People's Initiative. He warns the former president remains very influential.
Ang panawagan ni Pangulong Duterte, gayon din siguro ako, sasangayin ako doon, is for him to rein in the speaker, for him to rein in not only his political ally, not only his fellow member in the coalition, but also his first cousin. I hope he will not simply shrug his shoulders and look the other way as if nothing is happening. Right now, it's only the speaker being pointed to at this point in time as responsible for it. But at some point, tatamaan, babalingan, tulad ng ginawa ni Pangulong Duterte sa rally, at aabutan na rin siya. Maliban na lamang kung poposisyon nga siya. His silence will always be interpreted as acquiescence.
Former Senator Gringo Nasan weighing in on the rift between President Marcos and the Dutertes. On social media site X, Nasan said the effects of a divided society, people, and armed forces are unacceptable to every Filipino, considering the current global political issues that Filipinos must face with a united front. Nasan also appealing to President Marcos and former President Duterte to talk things out. Nasan is a former military official who played a vital role in the 1986 People Power Revolution that ousted the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., father of the current president. Nasan also led a series of failed coup attempts during the administration of the late President Cory Aquino. With a growing rift between President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his UNI team allies, the Dutertes. See, Marcos's predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte, warned Marcos may suffer the same fate as his father if the current administration insists on pushing for a people's initiative to amend the charter.
Pag pinilit mo ito, lalabas ka ng Malacañan kagaya noong panahon na pinalayas kayo. And constitution is supposed to be a permanent thing. Huwag ninyong pakialaman ang constitution kasi yun ang bahay opisyal ng Pilipino. Anak ka ng... Bakit pumasok sa utak ninyo yung People's Initiative? Anong nakain ninyo? There's nothing wrong with the Constitution right now. Alam mo, sa umpisa pa lang, nagdududa na ako. Bakit? People's Initiative manggaling sa tao. Dito, mga congressman, alam ninyo, kung magkaletsi-letsi yung buhay na ito. Sabihin ko sa military, sirahan ninyo yung Congress. Bakit binababoy ninyo ang bayan natin?
Duterte also accusing Marcos of being a drug addict.
Si Bongbong Marcos bangag noon, ngayong presidente na, bangag natin ang presidente. May drug addict tayo na presidente. Nung ako'y mayor, pinakitaan ako ng evidence ng PDEA. Doon sa listahan, nandoon yung pangalan mo. Ayaw kong sabihin yan kasi magkaibigan tayo. Kung hindi magkaibigan, magkakilala. Ikaw, pumapasok kayo ng alanganin. Mr. President, baka susunod ka sa dinaanan ng tatay mo. Diyan ako takot. Ayaw ko mangyari sa iyo yan.
When he was president, Duterte questioned the qualifications of one presidential contender whom he claimed is an illegal drug user. He did not directly name Marcos at that time. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency for its part denies President Marcos was ever included in its watch list. Well, former President Duterte's son, Davao City Mayor Sebastian Duterte, meanwhile, called for the resignation of President Marcos. He made that remark during a leaders' forum in Davao City opposing charter change. The mayor also accused the president of being lazy and lacking compassion.
All of these things that he is causing is oppressive.
oppressing the people. Mao mabu na. Kay giuna niya ilang politika, ilang self-preservation sa ilang politika. Wa nila giuna ang trabaho. So karon, imbes of opening up new opportunities, especially for those sa lower classes, kaya para mo improve ang kinabuhi sa mga Pilipino, labi na sa mga kapos. Mr. President, kung wala kay gugma, kung wala kay aspirations sa imuhang nasod, resign.
Well, also present during the event, the former Executive Secretary of President Marcos, Attorney Vic Rodriguez.
At nais ko pong sagutin kung bakit ako narito ngayong hapon. Sapagkat nakalagay doon sa isang post na aking nabasa, ang Davao City at ang Davaoenos are not for sale. And precisely for this reason that I am here, because your friend Vic Rodriguez is not for sale. Marami yata talagang elemento sa pamahalaan natin ngayon. Ang iniisip lamang ay ang kanilang sarili, kung paano manatili sa kapangyarihan at paano higit pang gustayin ang kapal ng bayan.